Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of the Nexus Podcast. Today we are joined by the one and only Emmanuel Kabongo, who portrays Raj in season 3 of the hit Netflix series Outer Banks, which is released on Netflix February 23rd. Thank you so much for taking time out of your schedule to join us today, Emmanuel.
Thank you very much for having me. I appreciate it.
No worries. Really appreciate it as well. Before we dive straight into the Outer Banks talk, I want to speak briefly about some of the other projects you've starred in over the years. You know, you've been in short films, web series, you've played reoccurring characters in major TV shows. You've also portrayed, I think it was a lead role in the Netflix show 21 Thunder. And this year, was it Chateau Lorraine, which just came out? Yeah. So this is an extensive list of projects, and it just shows how much experience you've had in the industry and what an amazing actor you've turned out to be. However, what project would you say was the catalyst for you? What was something that elevated you and helped you push that boundary to become the actor you are now?
Well, that's a very, very good question. I've been very fortunate to have an opportunity to play all these different characters and alongside other wonderful actors and work for one of the production companies. And so to go back, I've enjoyed every single character and every opportunity I've had, but I guess the turning point for me was an indie film I did a few years back. I think it was 2014. It premiered at the Toronto Film Festival and had other festival runs, and it was called The Animal Project. And that film, it was an indie film, and I was one of the leading actors in the film, basically kind of catapulted my career into the next level, getting more exposure and on a grander scale, you know, with major festivals. I was very, very fortunate and grateful for that opportunity by the filmmaker. Animal Project.
Cool. Yeah, I'll check that out after this.
Wait, and then also I produced and starred in a web series called Teenagers.
Oh yeah, I've heard of that actually.
Yeah, and that too was kind of helped turn around a lot of things in my career. So yeah,
I want to speak briefly about your experiences on 21 Thunder, portraying Junior in the series. I think this was one of your first lead roles as well. So I'm sure it would have been before that short films and cameos. So what was it like at this time of your career to portray a lead character on a Netflix show like Junior that has room for an arc and carries over loads of episodes?
Well, to be quite honest, I was very, very happy and kind of caught by surprise when I was cast for the role of Junior. And I thought, you know, they were going to go with a much younger actor for the role. But I guess, you know, the ability to transform and get into character kind of helped. So with that character, it was a dream come true. Why? Because originally I didn't want to be an actor. I wanted to play football. I wanted to be a soccer player. You know? So fast forward now, I get into acting. In the beginning, when I first got into acting, I was still playing in leagues and in football leagues. Opportunity on 21 Thunder gave me a chance to not just act but also play football. You know, so I remember while on set, they wanted to use a stunt double for all my soccer. But I said, no way, that is not happening.
It's not going to happen. If you're a fan of football, you have to
play. Exactly. You know, so it was a tremendous time. I connected with the cast and the writers, and it was unfortunate that we didn't get a second season, but I really believe everything happens for a reason.
Yeah, 100%. That was going to be my second question, actually, because I'm a massive fan of Ted Lasso. Have you seen that show?
Yeah, well, I know some guys on the show.
Oh,
I actually had an opportunity to watch the show yet, but it's on my list.
Yeah, it's really good. You should check it out. But yes, it's another football series. And I always wondered how they get all these scenes on camera, because they need the actor to hit the ball at a certain point, certain position.
Yeah.
So I have to ask, was that the same for you guys in 21 Thunder? And did you find it a little difficult, but also fun to film a show like that?
Well, yes and no. The difficulties were sometimes the weather wasn't always on our side, you know, so we had to work around that. We filmed it in Montreal for 3 months, and at that time I get very cold very quickly. And we filmed in Montreal in the fall, like end of summer. And so it got cold very quickly. One of our first days, we had this big soccer scene. I think it's when Junior Lolo is first introduced and he scores this major goal. Man, I remember when we had to do that scene and it was raining and they wanted me to kick the ball from midfield. And I mean, I could get it, but it was raining.
The weather
really raining that day, and the ball was wet.
It does not help, man.
And it was cold. So my
That does not help at all, man.
But after a bunch of tries, you know, I was able to capture one kick, and that was actually the one they used in the final take. But overall, you know, filming a show like 21 Thunder, which is on location, so a lot of the sets aren't built, you know, so we were using a real stadium, we were using real locations and hotels. The challenge was, you know, traveling from one end to another, you know, sometimes it was traffic, sometimes, you know, some background actors couldn't make it. And so, you know, in terms of like keeping the consistency of the show, you know, people had to be shuffled around. But the producers and the creators, you know, made it all work.
I can imagine. I haven't really seen all of it yet, so I'll definitely try and check it out if I can find it. I'm going to move on to talk about Outer Banks season 3. Obviously, your character Raj, he'll make his debut appearance on the series this season. So tell us briefly how you landed the role, how the audition process works, and what really attracted you to Outer Banks in the first place.
Well, first and foremost, I'm very grateful that I got the opportunity, and you know, thank you to the creators, Jonas and all the other creators involved. Just like any other audition, you know, most of the auditions that I get, because we are in a period of still having the pandemic affecting how auditionings are processed. At this point, when the audition came through, it was last year, beginning of summer, and it was a self-tape. And my wife, who was my fiance at the time, basically, you know, helped me with the self-tape, and I taped it. I think it was one or two scenes. It was two scenes, and we spent some time taping it, and I sent it off to my team, and I think a week later or a week and a half later, I found out that they were interested. So I did not know about the show at first, and it was my wife who put me on the show. She's like, I really like the show, and you auditioned, you know, like, you know, and you're going to be on it. So I started watching the show, and I said, oh, this is pretty cool, and followed along. And when I got the show, I flew to South Carolina, and it was great. Everybody on set was wonderful. And then it was back and forth. I flew to South Carolina a couple times, and then Barbados to do some scenes as well.
Awesome.
Funny enough, one of the actors that is also new on the show in this third season is actually a fellow classmate of mine.
Incredible.
His name is Andy McQueen, and he's also on the show. And when it's funny how we bumped into each other. I was sitting in my hotel, and I hear somebody call my name, Emmanuel, and I turn around and I see Andy. I'm like, oh, Andy. Yeah, it was cool because we both went to the we attended the Canadian Film Center.
Wow, it's a small world, man. Small world.
In Toronto, and so it was just like a full circle moment, you know, just like thinking about how we were both in this program, and now we're both on this show. So it was fun. It was a good time.
That seems incredible, man. I'm glad you had a great time. So going into more about your experiences on set, you've worked with the likes of Chase Stokes, Madeline Klein, many more. Do you have a favorite person specifically that you enjoy to work with, or someone that you learn a lot from?
I'm always learning, you know, whether it's from actors in front of the camera or people behind the camera, the crew, the writers, producers, directors. But in terms of in front of the camera, it was really nice connecting with Chase. He told me his journey and how he got to where he got, you know, kind of reminded me of my journey as well. He's a bit much, he's a bit younger than I am, but just hearing his humble story, you know, allowed me to connect with him, which was great. Madeline was also down to earth. Charles Esten, who plays.
That is really nice as well. Yeah.
Everybody was nice. JD.
Yeah.
Was, you know.
Rumors. Yeah, they were incredible people.
And Madison was also wonderful. But with Chase, it was actually cool because he in a way, like through him, I ended up getting my next job.
Oh wow.
Yeah, I ended up getting this movie that filmed in Dominican Republic. And funny enough, one of the actors in the film that I went to do in Dominican was Austin North.
Oh, wow. Awesome.
We had never worked. Wow. We didn't have scenes together in Outer Bank. Cool. But then, you know, when I got on the set of this movie in the Dominican, I saw that Austin was part of it and we connected. I was like, yeah, man, I just came from filming your show, but it's just funny enough that I got this movie. And because of Chase, you know, Chase was apparently working with the same producers, but on a different movie elsewhere.
Amazing. Yeah, you've had a lot of experiences.
Yeah. So he and I connected and it just so happened that this opportunity came and I got this movie, you know.
Crazy. Him, yeah.
Putting a good word.
Yeah, that's amazing. So I'm going to speak a bit about your character now, Raj. Try and tell us what you can about him without giving too much away for the viewers, of course.
You know, I don't, you know, off this out. The Outer Banks Instagram page just dropped a new poster. Mm. And tomorrow I think they're gonna drop
the trailer. So
I'm very excited to see what, you know, how that pans out. But in terms of Raj, you know, I let's just say, you know, it's a how do I say this without giving too much away? I'm not too good and I'm not too bad, you know. Like right in the middle, you know. I think in general, fans are going to be excited. You know, it's action-packed. And with a lot of unexpected turns of events. Mm. And for my character, I hope that, you know, I'm in a few episodes. I hope that people resonate with it because, again, you know, it's a wonderful show. It's got a great following. And that's all I could say for now.
Yeah, I can't wait to see how your character plays out. To end it off, though, I thought we could play a little game to get to know your character without giving away any spoilers, without you giving any spoilers away. So I'm going to read out four dilemmas and you can tell us what your character Raj would do in that situation. So I have the first one here. So you're on a desert island and you find a bag of cash. Next to it, you find a treasure chest. It could have more value in it than the bag of cash, but it could also have nothing in it. A storm is closing in and you only have time to pick one. What would your character go for, the treasure chest or the bag of cash, and why?
The treasure chest. Mm. Because, again, you know, I might be able to find something valuable there that's way worth than what money could buy, you know, or probably more than the bag of money. So I'll take my chances for the treasure chest. I like surprise.
Yeah, cool. Second question. Your house is on fire whilst you're inside. Your best friend is also inside the house. You can only save yourself or sacrifice yourself to save your friend. There's not enough time for both. Who would your character Raj save, himself or his friend?
Ooh, I think Raj would probably save himself, you know.
Oh.
So, and then after he saves himself, he'll try to live his best life to honor his friend.
Wow, interesting. Third question. You are searching for a treasure. Along the way, someone who knows a lot of information about this treasure helps you to find it. You find it and open the chest, have millions of dollars. The person who helped you find it, though, is demanding for 50% of the cut. Will your character Raj share it with him or keep it to himself?
Oh, yeah. Raj is definitely sharing.
Oh, it's interesting.
Yeah, yeah, he's definitely sharing. He's loyal.
Interesting. Fourth question. Final question. Your family is going on holiday and they ask you to come with them, which was your original plan. However, your best friends are also going on holiday at the same time and they ask you to come. Who would your character Raj go on holiday with, his family or his friends?
Raj will definitely go on holiday with his family. Family comes first. Again, Raj is loyal.
Awesome. Yeah. Okay. Now I have a bit of a better idea about your character, but still, I can't wait for it to come out, man. Thank you so much for this, Emmanuel. That's all from me. Have a good rest of the week, man.
Thank you. You too, my friend. All right. All the best.